Traditionally, according to SLP spokesman on education Gibeon Ferdinand, the local education system is based on the grammar school model. He says a lot needs to be done to make it relevant to the technical world. He says technical education needs to be advanced and access to tertiary education needs to be improved. Mr. Ferdinand was speaking against the backdrop of comments made by senior University of the West Indies lecturer Danny Roberts. According to Mr. Roberts, small island developing states like Jamaica need to rethink the pathway to quality employment by emphasizing a fundamentally instrumental role for TVET in providing the requisite human capital to meet the skills requirements for sustainable development.
The curriculum is constantly being reviewed, which is a good idea. But as we speak, I think technical education in St. Lucia needs to be advanced. And the idea of ICT also needs to be advanced so that education becomes a more relevant tool for empowerment and development of our labor force.
Mr. Ferdinand is hoping that this will be a top priority should the Labor Party assume office following the next general election.
As far as relevance to the workforce, we have a long way to go, and I'm hoping that that will be one of the issues that is high on the agenda of the Labor Party, which has been signaled by the political leader's concept of the youth economy, where you marry the idea of the quality of education you provide, the quality of opportunities you provide for young people to be able to function in the labor force. But I will agree that as it is in Jamaica, that statement that was made, most of the Eastern Caribbean countries are in that situation where they would want to review their education system.
Mr. Ferdinand commended the current administration for its efforts to revamp the education system, but he believes there's still a long way to go. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.